Hi everyone. Today we are having an interview with Jendrik Sigwart, who is representing Germany in this year's Eurovision with the song "I Don't Feel Hate."
Hello.
Hello. But first, welcome Jendrik, and congratulations with a spot in the final of the Eurovision.
Thank you so much.
We are so happy to have you there. How does it feel?
Still unbelievable. Like it was a dream. It's a dream coming true. So it's still not. It doesn't feel real right now, you know, because I was a small actor before that, and now that I've got so many followers, like it's not many, but for me it's many, yeah. And like there's so many people wanting to have interviews and stuff, and I'm like, why with me? Because I'm not really interesting at all. But it's such a great experience to have, and it's still unreal.
Yeah, cool. It's a Eurovision it's a big family, so I think it's overwhelming because
it's very so welcoming people. Family. Yeah. Like everybody's very welcoming.
That's really good to hear. A lot of Norwegian fans are very interested to get to know you more. So how are you? Is it busy these days?
Actually, I had quite relaxing days, yeah. For the last 4 days. The weekend and the last 2 days were quite chill and very relaxing. But we had the weeks before that were... we had a lot to do. Like we shot the backup video, the live on tape video in Lithuania. We had a lot of interviews. We planned the whole thing, and now we actually, because we saw when we were in Lithuania, we saw that the live on tape video is not exactly what we want to do in Rotterdam. Like we saw it, and we were like, "Oh, it's not quite what we want." So we're hoping now to be live in Rotterdam, and now we're changing the whole staging and the whole LED content, so that it's more what we want to show when we are in the Netherlands.
Very exciting. That's one of my questions, though, about the staging. Do you have some thoughts that you can share with us, or is it?
well, I'm definitely going to be on stage with my peace sign. It used like with in the music video, it's a middle finger, but for the Eurovision contest, it all of a sudden turned into a peace sign. I don't know why. It actually fits better to the song, so that's perfect. She's going to be on stage with me, and I have three backing singers also from the music video. My friends who will be joining me on stage, who will also be dancing with me and will also be playing the horn section.
Yeah. For me. Oh.
So those will be the people who will be on stage with me. But like the whole what's going on in the background and the video, it's still in a process as we change it all now.
Yeah, right.
we want to make it like as much our vision as we can.
Yeah. We are looking forward to see your show, though.
Me too.
But Jendrik, first of all, can you please tell the Norwegian who is Jendrik?
Who's Jendrik? Jendrik is an optimist in training. So I try to be optimistic most of the time. So it doesn't work all the time. But I'm in training, so I'm not a professional in it yet. But every time I get like I'm seeing things negative again, I try to remind myself, no, Jendrik, you try to do it differently. So I'm trying to become more optimistic in that sense. That is me in general.
Yeah, your background story. Do you have much experience with singing and performing?
I'm actually a trained musical theater actor. I studied that for 4 years, and I've been in the job for 2 years. I have been in the job for 2 years until Corona happened. And I also wrote my own music since I started in my piano lessons as a little child. My piano teacher, he was like, no, come, we're going to try something new. Let's try to invent music. And that's how I got the taste of inventing music. And then I started writing my own songs on the ukulele when I when I first had the ukulele in my hands when I was 17, 18, I don't know. But since then I wrote my own music, and now it's finally time to share that music with the world.
I'm
stage performances, I'm used to that.
Yeah, perfect. So why Eurovision then?
Well, it is a dream, seriously. Like, as a child, me and my family, we always watched it. Mm-hmm. I have a big family. I have four siblings and both my parents. And as children, we always watched the Eurovision Song Contest, and I actually called for people too. And then during the studies, we had big events during the Eurovision Song Contest. Like, one of my friends, he made a huge live stream. We actually had shots for every country, like for Greece, we drank ouzo, for Germany, Jägermeister, for Russia, vodka. Like, we had different shots. And so those were always big parties. And like, I was always amazed by the diversity and all the colors and how everybody can just be who they are and just like the freak out, you know? Everybody could be who they wanted to be at the Eurovision Song Contest. So that's what I really found impressing for all those years that I watched it. And that's why I said to my friends, one day I'm going to stand on that stage.
And now?
It happened. It's going to happen, hopefully.
Yeah. And now you're going to represent Germany in Eurovision. Can you tell us about how you got chosen?
Yeah. Well, actually, because I'm not really popular. Like, I'm not popular at all. Like, I don't have a name yet as a artist. So I wasn't able to audition to apply for the Eurovision.
Yeah, yeah.
It was not possible for me because they only called people from, I don't know, The Voice of Germany or from other series, or people with name. They called them and said, hey, do you want to audition for the Eurovision Song Contest? I wasn't able to. So my only way to make, like, to bring the attention to me was to yell it out in the world. So I made those little TikTok videos where I said, yeah, hello people, I'm creating a music video right now. Get me to the Eurovision Song Contest, please. Hello, I want to audition for the Eurovision Song Contest. Watch those little videos. And because of those TikTok videos, somebody actually messaged me on Instagram and said, hey,
yeah,
are you really interested in the Eurovision Song Contest? Because I might have the connections, but I need you to send me my song, which of course is tricky because sending to a person you don't know your song. He said, oh, okay, I get if you don't want to, because I'm a stranger and I could steal your song, or I could be a criminal. I was like, here, please, here's my song. Get me to the Eurovision Song Contest. And and that's how I got into the first round of the Eurovision Song Contest. And then we had actually multiple rounds, I think three or four. And like, we had in the first round, I think they decided, like, there's two juries who decided, like, who rated the artists in the first round. The artists were rated. Wow, that's hard to say. The artists were rated, and in the second round, the songs were rated. No, I can't say that. I'm very smart. And in the third round, there was actually a live performance. So that was where we actually stood on stage with the song with us and had to perform the song live, and they recorded it and sent those to the juries, and they rated those, and then I got picked to NDR, which is the broadcasting agent, like who organized the whole thing.
Yeah.
They did not choose me because those juries did. I was chosen, and I still don't know why, because all the other artists were so amazing.
But still you're here. Congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you.
But you have a song that really stands out in the field in this year's Eurovision. It's a very happy and cherry in the words, and you have a and then the refrain just blow people minds. Can you tell us about your song?
Well, yeah, the song is called I Don't Feel Hate. Mm-hmm. And I wrote, like, the message of the song, I wrote it as a reminder for myself and others. You know, like, I don't think there's any person in the world who has not felt hate before. Like, I have felt hate, and there's others too. But in a moment where I was like, oh, this person is so mean to me right now. Oh, she's so mean to me. I said to myself, no, Jendrik, come on. You're better than that. It doesn't, like, it's not good for you to feel hate because you just feel grumpy because of it. And it's not good for the other person either because she won't learn anything from it. So I said to myself, I'm going to go a different way. I'm not going to hate back. I'm not going to fight fire with fire. I'm going to fight fire with respect and love, which in the literal sense doesn't make, like, you can't fight fire with love. But just say if it's water, like, respect and love in a sense of water, and then you can fight fire with water. And that's what I tried to do,
right.
to go a different way. And so I wrote this song as a reminder to that. And also, I really wanted to spread, instead of negativity and hate, I wanted to spread enjoyment, and I wanted to spread joy and happiness and just having fun with the song. And that's initially how I wrote it, just to have fun with it and to put smiles in people's faces. And that's why the song got created, to put smiles in their faces.
And people really need joy now. So
they always do, I think. It's like, there can't be enough joy in the world.
That's right. The pandemic makes it difficult to promote the songs, difficult to promote the songs this year. How are you going to promote your song?
I don't know. Yeah, of course, all the live events aren't happening. Like, there's a lot of live events that won't be happening. But I'm just going to put stuff on the internet, you know, just show my perspective of the whole thing, and I want to talk about the song and I want to perform it in different ways. So that's what I'm going to do, to show the different perspectives of the song online.
Yeah. That's really clever, I think, because it's really difficult now. It's not as the other years when it's normal Eurovision. It's a different year and more difficult for people now. But Eurovision has a big history then, with a lot of music. Do you have any Eurovision favorites?
Well, yeah, of course. Who doesn't have any Eurovision favorites? Well, actually, my ultimate... No, let's start with, like, just once that, like, one of the first songs that really impressed me was actually Alexander Rybak's Fairy Tale. And just because I used to play the violin too. Like, I played the violin for a really long time. I can't, if I say now, 11, 13 years, and then you hear me play the violin, you'd say, oh no, he just played for 2 years. So I'm too scared to say a number, but I played it for a long time. And so to see somebody perform on stage and play the violin in a pop song instead of a classical piece was really impressive for me as a child, because I was like, oh, that's cool to see the violin in a cool pop song. That was one song that really stood out to me. And my ultimate favorite right now is actually Dari's Think About Things from last year, because it was just a upbeat, fun song. And I can't wait to meet him, to tell him that his song was my favorite and is still my favorite Eurovision Song Contest song to this day.
It will be really exciting to meet them though now.
Yes.
We are almost coming to an end of the interview. Do you have some words for the Norwegian fans out there?
I just don't forget that behind the whole competition and like the reason why the Eurovision Song Contest exists is to enjoy music and to come together to celebrate music and community. And I think a lot of times the Eurovision Song Contest fans, they forget that like the competition is only there to entertain, but the main reason why the song contest exists, and that is the main thing that I want to focus on this year, and that's what I would love to have a lot of viewers to focus on too, is to just celebrate the music and just have fun, because that is what's ultimate, like that is the reason why the whole thing exists, to come together and celebrate music and to not hate on each other's music.